All right, joining us on Hot Copy today, we'll be talking about many issues. We have Acting Palace Spokesperson Carlo Nograles. Secretary Nograles, good morning to you.
Magandang umaga sa iyo, Karen, at magandang umaga rin po sa lahat ng mga nanonood. Good morning.
All right. Umpisahan na po natin, Secretary, with the executive summary of the partial report of the Blue Ribbon Committee on Farmily. May we please get the statement from the palace regarding this? Clearly, the Senate committee has given very strong recommendations against certain personalities and even the health secretary.
Well, una sa lahat, hindi pa yan adopted ng committee, no? Partial pa lang yan and unofficial, kumbaga. At hindi pa yan inadopt ng committee or kahit ng Senado. So it's just right now something that we cannot really comment on kasi hindi pa naman yan official and it's just a partial report, no? So mahirap magsalita about it kasi wala rin kaming official copy rin. Pangalawa, siguro with that being said, ang gusto lang siguro naming sabihin is paulit-ulit na sinasabi naman ni Pangulong Duterte sa kanyang Talk to the People program, no? Ang lagi niyang sinasabi is sa kanya, file niyo ng kaso ang kailangan yung file ng kaso. Ang gusto niyang file ng kaso, wala siyang pinoproteksyonan dito. No? At kung sino man ang dapat kasuhan, eh kasuhan na ninyo. Yun lang, at one point, sinabi lang din ni Pangulo na yung paulit-ulit na mga tanong at kumbaga pati yung trabaho ng kanyang mga kalihim ay naapektuhan na at may kinakaharap po tayong pandemya, eh dun lang po umaksyon si Pangulo na kailangan magtrabaho na yung kanyang mga kalihim. At yun naman po ay isang question of law na ngayon ay pending sa Supreme Court. Kaya tayo na lang siguro namin yung talagang report na adopted talaga ng committee. Kasi right now, all we're hearing are things that are being reported in the media na wala naman kaming official copy niyan.
Okay, just very quickly, let's not forget that at one point, sinabi po ng Pangulo, ngayon wala siyang pinoproteksyonan. Ngunit nagdaan din ang panahon na dinipensahan po niya si Michael Yang at maging po ang iba na involved sa Farmily deal. At isa sa rekomendasyon po doon ay i-deport ang dalawang personalidad, kabilang po si Yang at ang isa pang Chinese surnamed personality, no? Binanggit po ni Sherry Ann Torres. Nangangahulugan po ba na kung i-adopt po ito ng Senado, Malacanang will also heed the deportation recommendation of the Senate?
Again, no, ang sinasabi ni Pangulo, kung ano yung kung sino ang dapat kasuhan, kung anong dapat gawin, eh gawin. Mm-mm. Ano yung dapat at sino man ang dapat kasuhan, kasuhan. Ang hindi niya lang gusto is that nagagamit nga yung Senate hearing bilang plataforma para sa politika na nadadamay yung trabaho ng kanyang mga kalihim. Kaya pinagbigyan niya at one point, pero at one point nung napansin na niya na paulit-ulit na yung mga tanong at ganun lang din, wala namang... At minsan nga, walang tinatanong pero pinapatawag, nagsasuffer na yung public service. And that was at that point when feeling niya na pagbigyan na niya no, as due respect to the Senate, at that point, sinabi niya na trabaho na tayo, let's focus now on the pandemic response. No? But again, paulit-ulit yung sinasabi, kasuhan ninyo... Kung gusto ninyong kasuhan, durugin ninyo kung sino ang gusto ninyong durugin. Pero wag lang madamay ang ating pandemic response at ang trabaho ng gobyerno laban sa COVID.
All right, moving now to another topic. Let's talk about the pandemic exit plan of the government. Step one, many senators are already open to the removal of the alert level system. Is it time already, Secretary, to remove the alert level system, given that you have more than 90% of NCR already fully vaccinated at this point at marami ang naka-booster shots na rin?
Hindi pa po panahon para tanggalin yung alert level system. Kasi gaya ng sinabi mo, Karen, no? Sa NCR, yes, okay lang yung mataas yung ating vaccination, but we still have to ramp up the vaccinations sa iba't ibang mga regions. Although we're seeing very, very good numbers now in the different regions, no? Number one. Number two, even the health experts will tell you that we hope na itong Omicron would be, or the Delta, I'm sorry, the Delta would be the last variant of concern na deadly. And hopefully, the next mutations will go the way of Omicron, meaning to say, kahit na more transmissible, less deadly siya for, or less fatal siya for the fully vaccinated. No? And hopefully, hopefully that's where it goes. No? But again, we have to see. Tingnan muna natin kung yan ba yung direction patutunguhan ng any further mutations or further variants of interest or variants of concern. That being said, hindi pa natin pwedeng tanggalin yung alert level system. Pero iba ang usapan if you say pwede na ba mag-alert levels 1, no? Ang ilang lugar.
Let's talk about that. First of all, what is the barometer that the IATF is looking for the alert level systems to be removed? Kasi po, alam natin may ibang mga bansa na sa Europa. The continent of Europe is already considering that COVID be seen as a regular virus, that it's there to stay. So may mga ganon. The UK, for example, is treating it, I mean, much more than the common cold, pero quite similar to the flu. So nandun na ang ibang bansa. Nagbubukas na po sila at tanggap nila, posible kang magka-COVID.
Yeah, that's alert level one. That's alert level one. Because in alert level one, Karen, pagdating ng alert level one, lahat ng mga restrictions in terms of indoor-outdoor capacity, mawawala na lahat yun. So sa alert level 2, 50% indoor fully vaccinated, 70% whether you're vaccinated or not, in certain establishments, nakalagay doon, number 1 to 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. Pagdating po ng alert level 1, very simply, ang nakalagay lang po sa alert level 1 is intrazonal and interzonal movement allowed without regard to age, and even comorbidities. And number two, all establishments, persons, or activities are allowed to operate, work, or be undertaken at full on-site or venue seating capacity, provided consistent with minimum public health standards, provided further that face-to-face classes for basic education shall be subject to prior approval of the Office of the President. So meaning to say, lahat ng mga sinasabing limitations in terms of percentages, mawawala yon, halos back to new normal na tayo, but very clearly na nandyan po yung minimum public health standards. Plus, hindi tayo pwede mag-alert level 1 until number 1, yung ating total bed utilization is below 49%. Mean to say, yung COVID cases natin in the hospital beds is below 49%. Number 1. Number 2, yung ating two-week growth rate is zero or bumababa. Yung growth rate niya is decreasing. And number 3, yung ADAR mo is below one. So that's when we're really at the minimal risk classification. But the reason why hindi natin tatanggalin ng alert level 1 is para just in case.
No, ang alert level,
variant of concern.
Yung tanong ko, Secretary.
Sorry, para hindi natin pwede tanggalin yung alert levels. Sorry, hindi natin tatanggalin alert levels para just in case a new variant of concern or interest comes or nagsasurge ulit, mababalik agad natin so alert level 2. So maybe what we're asking for is kailan tayo mag-alert level 1, which is what you're saying na parang back to normal, but it's new normal because dapat mataas yung vaccination rate, especially for the A2 and A3, no, para mag level 1 pala, A2 and A3, which is our senior citizens, and those with comorbidities have to be 70% fully vaccinated or up or higher, no? And then many of the establishments are adopting already yung requirements natin for safety seal, which is para magkaroon ka ng safety seal is those establishments are already following the requirements for ensuring minimum public health standards are complied with in their workplaces.
Okay, so but just coming from the argument of presidential advisor for entrepreneurship Joey Concepcion, you've removed the quarantines for foreign travelers anyway, right? Fully vaccinated ones. When you travel across the Philippines, like Boracay, for example, even the RT-PCR requirement was removed again. So when you think about it, isn't it time already to really go on alert level one in Metro Manila and just let businesses flourish? Because there is no more no vax, no ride policy anyway. The requirements of private establishments, they do have requirements on vaccinated individuals to be inside, right? Unvaccinated is takeout. But in other words, isn't it time to just let private establishments make their own rules and let business flourish and go on alert level one? Because we are also vaccinating 5 to 11-year-olds.
Yes. So the protocols natin sa IATF, we do not de-escalate.
Okay.
Until every 15 days, no? So after every 15-day period. So titingnan natin by February 16 kung pwede na ba mag-alert level 1 ang NCR. Mm-hmm. Remember, we were looking at this possibility before nung December. Mm-hmm. Nung December. When the cases were really low, 2-week growth rate sa NCR was really low, the ADAR was very low, and our hospitals utilization rate was very low, and then COVID, and then Omicron happened, no? But again, tingnan natin by February 13 presumably, or February 12 or 13, we'll be taking a look again at the numbers of NCR kung pwede na ba siya mag-alert level 1.
Okay, and very quickly, Joey Concepcion is also advocating that we prioritize on attending or going back to face-to-face classes.
Yes.
And it makes sense. He says vaccinated kids belonging to 70% vaccinated households or no unvaccinated senior citizens in the house and living in areas with 80% of the population should already attend face-to-face classes.
Yes.
Right?
So
I mean, most public school teachers are vaccinated. Clearly, they're frontliners. And you are starting with a 5 to 11.
Yes. If you would remember, one of the talk to the people ni Pangulo, si Secretary Briones presented to President Duterte the proposal to expand yung face-to-face classes in other parts, especially pag nag-alert level 2 na. So now, there are several provinces, including NCR, that is already in alert level 2. Then we hope to be able to see a more, an expansion of the number of schools, public schools that already can do the face-to-face classes upon the assessment ng Department of Education, pati ng Department of Health. That being said, yung mga private schools na gusto na rin magsimula ng face-to-face classes, especially in the alert level 2 areas, can now begin making their representations with the Department of Education para mabigyan din sila ng pahintulot ng DepEd na mag face-to-face classes na rin sila.
Okay. At palagay niyo po, Secretary, kailan po ito sisimulan?
Well, right now it's alert level 2 in NCR, Batanes, Bulacan, Biliran, Southern Leyte, Cavite, Rizal, and Basilan. So yun, sa alert level 2, pwede na pong upon the DepEd assessment and the DOH assessment, they may now start expanding again face-to-face classes in the public schools, and then those in the private schools can already begin talking to DepEd.
Another question is, pinag-uusapan na po ba sa IETF ang pandemic exit plan?
Well, we've always been talking about that because meron kaming may sub-TWG kami on the recovery. So may task group kami dyan. And they're the ones that are building up and putting the details to this resiliency plan that we have, no? And that's the reason why slowly we've unti-unti no nakikita natin yung mga resolutions ng IETF that are beginning to open up industries, kasama na dyan yung sa tourism, di ba? Kasama na rin dyan yung sa face-to-face classes, kasama na rin dyan yung pag ano natin ng alert level, pag shift natin to the alert level system. Now we also have alert level 1 that we're also hoping to be able to implement, and that really puts a premium now in empowering now the people to do the proper protocols, yung minimum public health standards, because they are already fully vaccinated and many are already boosted.
Oo. Tanong ko lang quickly, are you seeing, Secretary, matutulad tayo tulad ng UK or other countries na tatanggapin na natin that COVID is like the flu? Kumbaga, we will start moving in that manner?
We have to wait for what the health experts will tell us, no? Right now, wala pa talagang consensus dyan, eh, no? The health experts are still wary about, of course, they are optimistic na papunta na yan sa parang flu na parang seasonal na because of what they saw with Omicron and because of what how they saw the vaccines operate, no? How the vaccines were able to really work, because even with the surge in the number of cases, you didn't see naman the same surge happening, a parallel surge happening sa hospitalization. So that shows that the vaccines work. So many are hopeful, but cautious pa rin yung optimism ng lahat. So it's still a little bit of wait and see, but there is hope in seeing this being more of like a seasonal flu. But again, people are, our health experts are very careful and they like to take it one step at a time.
All right. Two more questions, Secretary, but not any more related to COVID. Malacanang recently defended the granting of ABS-CBN's frequencies to certain personalities allied with Malacanang. But some sectors have said that the granting of these frequencies were quite arbitrary on the part of the government, of course, given by the NTC but sanctioned by the president. Here are the financial statements of these companies. Number one, Advanced Media Broadcasting System with the Villars had a net loss of 3 million in 2020, but to be fair to them, there were earnings over one sector. Kibuloy Swarasug, 20 million, and Aliu Broadcasting, 11 million. So you have Swarasug and Aliu with a deficit that has reached 218 million and over 50 million. So to be fair to AMBS, that's the parent company of Planet Cable, it had over 700 million in revenues in 2020. Pero ang tanong ng marami, why would these companies be given those frequencies when clearly lugi ang mga kumpanyang ito? They don't have the financial capacity. There was no transparent outright bidding for these frequencies. Bakit po binigay sa mga kumpanyang ito?
That's a NTC decision. No, the statement coming from Malacanang, and as I know it, coming from the Department of Justice, was that when NTC sought opinion from DOJ and sought opinion from Malacanang, there, or more specifically, the Office of the Executive Secretary, there was no mention of any personalities or names. There were just simply questions of law without naming any names. So when a decision was rendered by the DOJ and coming from the OES, it was based on a question of law without naming any names. So sinagot lang ng DOJ at sinagot lang po ng OES. But ultimately, it was NTC's decision.
Mm-mm. But would that be justifiable? I mean, given that you have Pastor Apollo Kibuloy, who's clearly openly an ally of the president, and he gets the DZMM franchise, a frequency, and his own company, Swarasug, has lost 20 million pesos in 2022, and you have Aliyo Broadcasting losing 11 million.
Well, it's again, it's up to NTC to answer those questions. They have their own rules and procedures. I'm not privy to the details doon sa loob ng NTC.
Mm-mm. Another question, you are also a high-ranking official of PDP Laban. And until today, the ruling party doesn't have its own presidential candidate. Ano ang plano ng PDP Laban, Secretary, sa totoo lang? You've already adopted Mayor Sara, but why won't PDP Laban adopt Bongbong Marcos? What is the problem?
Dumadaan pa ng proseso ng PDP Laban. We're still trying to seek consensus sa loob ng PDP Laban.
Mm-mm. Okay. Pero ano po ang, sino ba ang mga posibleng kandidato po na i-endorso ng PDP Laban? Posible po bang si Bongbong Marcos o si Isko Moreno? Kumbaga, may mga kandidato po bang pinagpipilian ang mga miyembro?
Well, yung ano kasi, yung bawat kandidato na tumatakbo bilang pangulo ay may kanyang partido, di ba?
Mm-mm.
So it's really a discussion not only with the personality himself but also with the party to party discussions din po yan.
Uh-oh. Because there are Isko Sara posters that are also out, and some have wondered, are those coming from PDP Laban?
Hindi po.
Okay, hindi po. So kailan ang anunsyo, Secretary, ng sino ang kandidato ng PDP Laban?
Well, abangan na lang natin, no, because syempre pinag-uusapan pa namin. Hindi pa, again, it's still a consensus building. We're still trying to get really a consensus from the party. Dumadaan pa kasi ng proseso yan, not just from the officials of PDP Laban, but obviously not just from the executive committee, but also with other officials, especially on the ground sa mga regions.
All right. On that note, maraming salamat po, Cabinet Secretary Carlo Nograles, for your time this morning, sir. You take care and you stay safe.
Thank you. Ingat din, Karen. Ingat po lahat. God bless everyone.
All right.